It's high school basketball, and tonight from Newburyport High School, we have the Division III game, part of the state tournament. This is the Mass IAA Division III North first round game featuring the Newburyport Clippers and Swampscott Big Blue. Clippers have a record of 17-3. Swampscott's record is 9-11, but they must have qualified as what they call the Sullivan rule, which means they made it come in second in their division. I think that's how it works if you're first and second.
Okay.
So there's supposed to be a 500 record, so that's the exception. So we're going to have the starting lineups.
Also, they might have played a lot of Division I schools and lost, and I think they go by their record. I'm not quite sure, but no, that's not correct. Okay, Richie,
yeah, it goes by the
total record.
Yeah.
It's not predicated on what division you play.
Here's number two, Cole Cassidy. Yeah, it's like football has that thing where you get bases based on larger runs. Number four is Jake Goldman.
Number 11, Jackson Byrne.
You got something on Jackson Byrne, haven't you?
Jackson Byrne is a co-captain, and he's the leading scorer for Swampscott in the last game. I'm told he made 11 three-pointers.
So you can watch it from the outside. Then.
So,
what team is Jack Leahy?
33 points from outside.
And 24 is Max Pignato, and the coach is Justin Fusillo.
Now
for the Clippers.
Number zero, George Coriel.
Like to see George drive the hoop tonight. He's been feeling better, I think, the last half of the season. Been showing it by driving to the hoop and getting fouled and getting some layups.
Number 13, Jake Robertson. Number three, Ryan Archie. Robertson, actually leads this area, is tied for this area, three-pointers for the Newburyport area.
Is he?
Okay. Parker McLean, number 40, McLaren, number 44.
And at four, number 22, Casey McLaren,
who was awarded the MVP of the league this year in this division.
The Clippers are coached by David Clay.
And David Clay, the coach for the Clippers. Now we'll have the playing of our national anthem.
Please rise now and honor America and all those who have served our country with the singing of the national anthem. Performed tonight by Newburyport High School junior, Julia Owens.
So it's an exciting time of year with the playoffs coming up and going on now. And Newburyport has the hockey team and the boys basketball team qualified. And we also like to congratulate Sam Aquavira from Newburyport. He came in third in the 2 mile in the state all-state race. He came in third place.
Yes.
So congratulations to Sam.
Yep.
A little bit of blonds out here for the Clippers. The majority of bleached their hair blonde, if you look at it.
Some fans from Swampscott who were right behind us originally thought they were all albinos.
So we're set to go. Clippers will be shooting the basket to our left, and Swampscott the basket to our right. Hey, Steve, a lot warmer here. Steve Leary, his son, is on the hockey team. Usually we see him freezing in the rink. Control with Clippers. McLaren with it.
one of the first indications of a team's effectiveness and readiness.
And we're going to jump ball.
Is their passing. You're going to look for crisp passing.
And possession now goes to Swampscott, so they'll have the ball first.
Newburyport in full court pressure.
Okay, Swampscott is Goldman bringing it up, guided by Coriel. Goes in and he's tripped, and it's going to be a foul on the play. Fouls on Coriel, his first. Swampscott's ball on the side. This would be Jackson Byrne. You gotta watch out for him. He's a good three-point shooter. Goldman over to Byrne. Byrne goes inside. Passes back out. Goldman. Now Pagnotto. Pagnotto. Pass inside. Byrne. Byrne shot is no good. Rebound by the Clippers. This is Robertson. Robertson over to Coriel. Back to Robertson. Robertson for three. He's got it. As I mentioned earlier in the game, when the Daily News lists the top scorers in the area, he's tied for three-point shots. That makes it his 50th. There's the three-point shot. There is good by Pagnotto. Max Pagnotto, and that makes the score 3-3. Coriel with the ball to Robertson. Robertson looks all the way across court. It goes to Archie. Three-point shot again by Robertson is good. Jake Robertson. And it's 6-3 Clippers.
And I noticed Casey was in the paint that whole offensive set. He's usually in the corner.
Byrne
got something different going on.
Byrne had it knocked away by Robertson. It became traveling as he had possession, but he traveled. So help by Robertson, that one caused the trouble. Number one coming in now for Swampscott.
Andrew Augustine. Swampscott with some full court pressure.
All right, there's a shot from the corner. It's no good this time. Tipped up out of bounds. And it's going to be
Newburyport ball.
Yeah. To Casey, and he goes down hard as he can get the ball. Here comes Augustine. And his shot is up around the rim and no good. Tipped out of bounds. It'll be Newburyport ball. Andrew Augustine with that shot at that time. He just got in the ball game, tried to go for breakaway. Looks like McLaren might be limping a little bit.
Yeah, I think he's got a little bump on the ankle, but I think he'll be fine. Gonna run it off.
Coriel over to Archie. Now McLaren, Parker McLaren. Parker drives, puts it up, no good, and he's fouled on the play. The foul's going to be in number 24, Max Pagnotto.
Newburyport had a hard time getting into their offensive set right there. I think the pressure upset the guard play a little bit, and so Parker ended up taking a one-on-one drive to the hoop.
Misses the first one. Here's one more coming. In the lineup now is number 21, Cam O'Brien. Second free throw coming. That's no good either. And it's rebounded by Byrne. Byrne over to Augustine.
Parker was a 69% foul shooter on the year for the regular season.
Augustine, Cassidy. Over to O'Brien. O'Brien drives, and he might have traveled. Yep, traveling. Took that extra step there. Now in the line, back in the lineup is Max Pagnotto, number 24, replacing Goldman.
Yeah, they're doing full court press, so they're probably going to use some fresh legs every minute
Archie
or so.
To Coriel. Coriel is fouled and played by Pagnotto. That's his second. Two fouls, so they're probably going to replace. Okay. That'll be number four, Goldman, coming back in the lineup. Wait, with this hair coloring for the Clippers, it's hard to recognize who they are. You got to look at the numbers for sure.
It is difficult, yes.
Nice styling. Coriel. Coriel breaks the press from straight down the middle. Coriel, nice move, lays it up and in. Nice play by George Coriel. 8-3 Clippers. That was a good move. Goldman. Over to O'Brien. O'Brien at the top of the circle. Over to Goldman. Now it's Augustin. Augustin. Augustin for three. It's no good. Rebound by Coriel. Coriel goes straight down the middle again. This time over to Archie. Archie from the corner for three. It's up to him. Up to him. No good. Tipped up. No good. Rebounded by Goldman. The drive by that was Byrne was no good. Rebound blocked by Parker McLaren down to Casey. Casey lays it up and no good, and he's fouled.
All right, so it's kind of hectic up and down right now. I think the coaches are going to try to get them settled down, get into their half-court offenses.
Casey McLaren going to shoot two.
Casey McLaren was a 74% foul shooter this year.
Free throw is good. 1 point. 9-3 Clippers. One more coming for Casey. Big crowd here tonight. Almost standing room only.
Yeah, and they're still coming in.
Two free throws by McLaren. 10-3 Clippers. O'Brien with the ball. Out front to Augustin. Augustin. Augustin, the top of the circle. Goes up for three. It's no good. Rebounded by the Clippers. That's Robertson.
All right.
Oops, excuse me. Let me try to move that out of your way. Augustin with the ball. The shot is up by O'Brien. It's good. Nice basket. That was by Cam O'Brien.
Yeah, Augustin went end-to-end with that. He's got to stop him halfway at the half-court mark so that he doesn't get those free layups.
Over to Robertson. Robertson, a little shot is good. Robertson's up to 8 points now, and it's 12-5 Clippers. Augustin with the ball. Over to O'Brien.
Keep an eye on Ryan Archie, number three.
He's going away by Robertson.
Keeping a good eye on Jackson Byrne, not letting him get the free shot.
Clippers pick it up. Down to Archie. Archie in the corner. It goes to Casey McLaren. Casey's shot is no good. He has a foul on the play. That's on Jackson Byrne. His first, fourth on Swampscott. And it'll be Clipper ball underneath. 12-5, Clippers lead, 3:12 to go in the first quarter. But Casey now, Coriel. Robertson in the corner. Looks cross court, it goes to Ryan Archie. Now it's Casey McLaren over to Coriel. Archie looks inside, he gets it to Parker McLaren. Parker from outside for three. It's rounded and in. Parker McLaren with a three-pointer. And it's 15-5 Clippers. Clippers up by 10. And timeout is called by Swampscott. So Clippers off to a big big lead here. Good shooting. The Clippers have had three three-pointers already. Robertson with two three-pointers for a total of 8 points. Parker McLaren is a three-pointer for three. And George Coriel and Casey McLaren each with 2 points. Plus, the Clippers played some pretty strong defense so far.
They have. They've been getting into the passing lanes, interrupting Swampscott's passes, preventing them from getting into their offensive sets. And that's the purpose of these half-court traps and pressures. I'm sure Coach Clay has gotten a scouting report from one of his buddies down there on the Cape Ann about Swampscott, what they like to do, when they're most effective. So Coach is going to take that away. He's putting a lot of pressure on the guards.
So 15-5 Clippers lead. One foul called against the Clippers, four against Swampscott so far. Watch this, Jeff, because you're not going to be a... Oh, well. We got such tight quarters. We got a box for our connections right between us, and keeps getting kicked. All right, in the corner goes Augustine for three. It's no good. Rebound by the Clippers. Coriel with another rebound. Down straight, it goes down, and Coriel drives, lays it up, no good, but he's fouled on a play.
And
George Coriel going to go to line to shoot two.
What happens a lot on those long shots, that was a three-point attempt.
Fouls on Coriel Cassidy, Cole Cassidy. I knew I was going to say that, Coriel Cassidy. I kept saying to myself, I knew I was going to say it. Coriel's shot is good. 3 points now for George.
And George was a 72% foul shooter during the regular season.
No good. Rebounded by Bruin. And get foul against the Clippers.
I think Coriel.
And that's going to be two on Coriel. You know, those foul, you get those foul shot percentages for the Clippers. Nobody's really that super high.
No, they're all right around 70, 72 to 78.
That's not really that super. They did it. We knew they had trouble at the line a lot, but no one's even at 80. Wow. But they, like you said, they're pretty close in the 70s. All
yeah,
of them.
Yeah.
Let's go Blue!
So Coach Clay is out wiping up some of the perspiration off the floor. I don't know if he got it all. I can still see a little bit of wetness out there. But we're going to go anyways.
2:28 go in the first quarter. Clippers with a press on. Pass goes over to O'Brien. Back to Augustine. And it's out of bounds. It'll be Newburyport ball. All right. Coriel brings it up. No, that's Gagnon's in there now.
Gagnon's,
sorry.
Yeah.
Augustine lays it up, round it in. Andrew Augustine. But 16-7. Clippers lead by nine. Gagnon with the ball. Robertson. Gagnon inside to Casey. Casey McLaren off the board. It's around him, no good. Rebounded by a new player, then number 23. That is Chris Campos. O'Brien shoots, no good. Rebounded by Parker McLaren. Down court, quickly down court it goes. In the corner for three, it's Archie. Ryan Archie for three. 19-7 Clippers. Burns shot is up around, no good. Rebound by Casey McLaren. Now it's Gagnon. Over to Robertson. Inside it goes. Back out to Casey McLaren for three. It's around the rim, no good. Rebound by Robertson. And stole it away. That was Goldman that stole it. Quickly down court it goes. The 3-point shot is good. That was by Burn. Well, he gets that ball away quick when he does take the three.
Looks like a Seth Curry type
19-10.
Shot.
19-10. Robertson is inside, passes in the corner to Casey McLaren for three. He, no good. And it's loose, knocked out of bounds. It'll be Swampscott ball. 27 seconds to go in the first quarter. Newburyport leads 19-10. Augustine with the ball.
Swampscott can hold it for the last shot here.
Augustine makes a good move, puts it up, and he's fouled on the play. Jake Robertson with the foul. That's his first. Andrew Augustine at the line, shooting two. First one's no good. Second one coming.
Let's go, Red!
Casey coming out, so he'll get an extended break.
Second shot is good. So Dustin now has 3 points, and it's 19-11 Clippers.
So 10 seconds left. Let's see who they go to in this situation.
Cross goes to Gagnon. Now it's going to be crossover to Robertson. Archie for three. It's no good. And the buzzer sounds, ending the first period. We will score Newburyport 19 and Swampscott 11. Also, Harry Bovey was in the lineup this time for Newburyport, too. I missed him when he came in.
Yeah, so Newburyport played with some good energy there. They played some tight defense. They forced some turnovers. I think the coach is quite happy so far, but they can't have any letdowns. Some of the cheerleaders from Swampscott performing here, getting the crowd all wound up. Did a great job.
Okay, in that first quarter, with the Clippers leading by a score of 19-11, Jake Robertson leads the scoring with eight, and 3 points each for George Coriel, Ryan Archie, and Parker McLaren, and Casey McLaren has two. Clippers made 4 3-point shots in the period, and the Clippers were 3 for 6 from the foul line. For Swampscott, Jackson Byrne and Max Pignato and Dustin Andrew Augustin each have three. Cam O'Brien has two. They made 2 3-pointers. They were 1 for 2 from the foul line. 5 fouls against Swampscott, 3 against Newburyport. Second period going to start, and it's Clipper ball.
George Coriel still on the bench. Gagnon running the show out here.
Over to Robertson. Robertson to Archie. In the corner goes to Casey McLaren. McLaren has a round rim and out. Augustin with the rebound. Augustin off to his left. Now he drives down the middle, puts it up. Nice move, but around him, no good. Rebound by Casey McLaren. Quickie to Gagnon. Gagnon over to Robertson. Robertson got it by Augustin. Bovey.
Swampscott trapping.
Outside to Gagnon. 14 seconds on the shot clock. Archie. Casey McLaren. McLaren passes back out to Archie for three. It's around the rim, no good. Rebounded by Bovey. Bovey puts it up and he's fouled. And Harry Bovey will go to line to shoot two.
Once again, Harry Bovey getting involved in a positive way, getting the rebound and getting fouled. That's 6 on Swampscott. The Newburyport will be 1-1. The next foul.
And Bovey missed both free throws. Rebound by Pignato.
That's unusual. Harry's a 77% foul shooter on the year.
7 minutes to go in the half. Clippers up by 8. And Byrne over to Goldman. Goldman now back to the foul line. A jump shot from the foul line is no good. Rebounded. Loose. Picked up by the Clippers. That was Robertson had the rebound. Gagnon with it to Casey McLaren from outside for three. Around the rim and out. Clippers have about 6 shots around the rim tonight. All 3-pointers.
That's the third for Casey, I think.
Ooh, almost a backcourt. They call it traveling, but it looked like it was a backcourt also.
Yeah,
Clipper ball.
Casey a little frustrated with the ball going halfway down and then coming out. But he's a great shooter, so he's just got to keep shooting. I think that's what Coach Tim McCann is telling him over there. Keep shooting. It'll go.
Robertson with the ball. Over to Archie. Casey McLaren in the corner.
Casey should be able to get the baseline.
And it's stolen away by Byrne. Byrne goes to his left, and it's going to be a foul against the Clippers.
Yeah, that was a little sloppy right there. Turnover and then a foul.
That's the second on Robertson, fourth on the team.
That's going to get Trevor Ward off the bench.
Yeah, Ward will replace Robertson for the Clippers. Pignato will put the ball in play. He does over to Augustine. Augustine. Augustine guarded by Ward. The foul line has it knocked away, but gets it back. Goes it back over the side. Shot is no good. Rebounded by Gagnon. That shot was taken by Pignato. Gagnon to Casey. Casey McClellan drives, passes over to Bovee. Bovee up front, it goes to Gagnon. Archie in the corner. Now to Casey. Casey, a turnaround jumper is good. Casey McClellan has four.
Something as simple as a little bounce pass is what triggered that basket by Trevor Ward.
Fouls on Max Gagnon. That's his first, fifth on the team.
Parker McLaren back in.
Clip is up by 10. 5:26 to go here in the first half. Goldman has a block by Casey McLaren. Now Goldman shot again, this time Parker with the rebound. Gagnon brings it up. And he has it knocked away, picked up by Parker McLaren, and he's fouled. Fouls on number 24, Max Pignato. That's his third.
Yeah, and that's going to be 1-1 for Newburyport now.
Parker McLaren to go to line. It's amazing, you know, the first six fouls, four of them were shooting fouls. So the Clippers had two shots on those. Normally you just take the ball out in the first six.
Yeah.
Four out of the six were shooting fouls. McLaren misses it, rebounded by Byrne. Byrne spins, makes a good move, puts up off the board, no good. Ball is loose. Nice pass to Augustine, and he's fouled on the play. Fouls on Casey.
Casey, yeah.
That's his first. Sixth on the team, and at the line is Andrew Augustine to shoot two, I think. Two shots, yeah.
So I think Newburyport would like to get out and run, and I think they're a little more athletic. Swampscott, on the other hand, I think likes this type of scrappy game, fouls, rough physicality underneath the boards.
First shot's no good. Second shot coming for Augustine. Shot is no good. We even see a bunch of fans from Newburyport with
the wigs, gold wigs.
Gold wigs, yeah. Ward back to Archie. Over to Ward. Ward goes inside to Parker. Now it's Parker right there. That's a good pass from Bovee.
Yeah.
Bovee to Parker McLaren.
Nice bounce pass in the paint. A lot of hands, a lot of arms in the paint from the defense.
So it's 23-11.
Bounce pass, it often works more effectively than a direct pass.
Parker McLaren trying to complete the three-point play the traditional way, and he did. And it's 24-11 Clippers. 6 points for Parker McLaren. 24-11 Clippers, 4:40 to go here in the half. The shot is no good from O'Brien. Three-point attempt. And nice play by Trevor Ward. Trevor bounced, threw it off the Swampscott's player, but then it hit Ward while he was out by the bounds.
Yeah, good effort. Yep.
So it'll be Swampscott ball. Byrne will put the ball in play to Goldman, and Goldman is fouled by Parker McLaren. Wow, that was a chintzy foul.
Yeah, and that's seven on Newburyport.
And McLaren, it's his first, and it's going to be 1-1 for Jake Goldman.
And I think Swampscott's going to have to start making these 1-1s.
Shot is no good. Rebound by Parker McLaren. Over to Casey. Now Archie. In the corner it goes. Back out to Archie. Trevor Ward. Casey McLaren around the rim and out again. Ball's loose, picked up by Swampscott. Goldman over to O'Brien. O'Brien drives. Now makes a good move, puts up no good. Tapped away by O'Brien. Swampscott now. Clippers get it back. Parker with it. Down court goes to Casey McLaren. Casey is fouled as he tried to pass it off. That's going to be on Byrne, his second. That's the ninth. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'm missing 1, 2, 3, 4, 8. So I'm missing one. I only have 8. They show 9 on the board. So we're going to see who it is later. But McLaren at the line. Casey shooting 1-1. No good. Rebound by Byrne. Byrne's shot is no good. Rebounded by Parker. Trevor Ward. Casey to Parker, and that's stolen away by the Big Blue.
That was number 2, Cole Cassidy.
Byrne to Augustin. And Augustin drives, puts the shot up, no good. Gets his own rebound, knocked away by Ward, but picked up by Byrne. His shot is no good. That's going to be a foul against the Clippers.
Yeah, it's not pretty, but it's
that's effective, on Ryan Archie, his first.
Although, I don't know if you can call it effective, 11 points with 3 minutes left in the first half.
Byrne going to be shooting 1-1.
Byrne's going to have to start shooting some threes, I think, in the second half to get them back into this game.
Three throws around him and out. Parker McLaren with a rebound. 3:05 to go in the half. Charlie Kaling in the lineup now for the Clippers, number 11. And there's going to be a foul here. It's foul on number 2, Cole Cassidy. And that's the 10th foul. And Parker McLaren is at the line shooting 2. Free throw is good. 7 points for Parker. One more shot coming. 25-11 Clippers. Second free throw. No good. Rebounded by Byrne. Over to Augustin. Augustin. Got it by Bovey. Augustin spins, puts a shot up, no good. Rebound by Parker McLaren. Over to Trevor Ward.
Nice one-on-one defense right there by
Archie to Charlie Kaling. Kaling traveled, I think. Yeah, traveling. No basket. Made a good basket, but he traveled. Yeah. That was a good call.
I was going to say down the other end, Harry Bovey made a nice one-on-one defensive play on Augustin. Or Augustin, I'm not sure.
All right. Augustin with the ball. Now it's O'Brien in the corner to Goldman. Goldman drives, lays it up, no good. Rebounded by Parker McLaren. Nice pass to Bovey from Archie. And he'll be traveling again.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. He had someone right on his back.
He almost picked up a technical foul,
too. Yeah, the referee's looking right at him, saying, keep your mouth shut. But that was a horrible, I usually don't say this, but I think that was a horrible call.
2:07 to go in the half. Clippers up by 14, 25-11. Very low-scoring quarter here. 6-0 Newburyport after 6 minutes. This could be an offensive foul on Byrne, and that's going to be his third.
And he's mouthing off, too. Referee might want to call a technical to get these guys in order.
Now we got a whistle here.
And I think the referee's going to give him a warning. I don't know why he's going over there and talking to the scorekeepers, the official scorekeepers.
We've got 6 guys on the court. Now, 11's out. That should be a technical foul. Six guys on the court.
There was for 3 or 4 seconds.
What?
They had 6 guys out there. Referee's got to get control of the game here.
Parker McLaren is stolen away by Augustin. Good steal there. Augustin drives, lays up, no good. There's going to be a foul on the play.
It's like Parker.
That's his second. Ninth against the Clippers, and Augustin has got a line to shoot. Two. Shot is no good. He's one for five from the foul line so far.
And correct me, Richie, but Swampscott, they've not scored this period yet?
Nope, they haven't.
They
it's
had 11.
It's 6-0 Newburyport.
6-0, wow.
Neither team scored much.
No, not been pretty.
Rebounded by Clippers. And lost the ball was Bovey. Swampscott gets it back, O'Brien drives. And his shot hasn't been good. O'Brien with his first two points of the quarter. 25-13. It'll be Clipper ball, 1:23 to go in the quarter. Casey McLaren will put the ball in play. Over to Archie. Archie to Ward. Casey McLaren in the corner. Ooh, almost a travel. Ooh, he kept his pivot foot. In the corner goes Casey. Jason drives, and he loses the ball, but he gets fouled.
Yeah, he sure did. That was number two, Cole Cassidy.
That's Cassidy. It's his third. They've got at least three players with three fouls now.
Yeah, and they're going to come off the bench with Jack Leahy, I think is pronunciation.
Casey at the line, shooting two. In fact, every foul the rest of the quarter, only 106 to go, is going to be a two shots, unless it's after a made basket. 26-13, Clippers. 27. Two free throws by Casey McLaren. He has 6 points. O'Brien, guarded by Kaylane. 1 minute to go in the period. Augustin with it. O'Brien's three-point shot is no good. Rebounded by Casey. Casey McLaren has it stolen away. Goldman to Augustin. 28 seconds to go in the quarter. Augustin. Inside it goes to Leahy. Leahy's shot is good. Jack Leahy with the basket. 27-15.
And you're very important.
They're probably hold for one.
Last shot here of the half.
Archie, seven seconds to go.
Yeah, they're going to get going.
Kaylane, they're not going to get it off. And the buzzer sounds ending the half. So Clippers couldn't get the shot off. Oh, it's 27-15 as that quarter. Clippers only scored 8 points, and Swampscott scored four. Very low scoring second quarter.
So we did not see Swampscott attempt many threes. They were consistently attacking the basket, and I think they were running into Casey and Parker quite a bit. So they might go into the locker room here at halftime and try to discuss attempting some more threes.
27-15, Clippers lead, and just to recap it, part of the Clippers there that quarter, 27 points. Clippers had 4 3-pointers, and it was 7 for 15 from the foul line, so that's
a little under
50%, right. And for Swampscott, they were only 4 points that quarter. They have 2 3-pointers in the game. And let me see, they're only 1 for 8 from the foul line.
Nice round of applause here for the Newburyport Junior Clippers. They played in a tournament recently and came home with 2 wins and no losses.
All right, I'm going to swing over. You could talk about what you're talking about this at halftime here, but I'm going to go over and check the fouls because I had one foul that they had that I didn't have for the other team, for Swampscott, okay. So I'm going to go check that out. All right, we're going to pause right now, and then we'll be back for the second half, so don't go away.
So welcome back to the Institution for Saving Court here at Newburyport High School. My name is Jeff Foley, and I'm here with Richie Eaton, and here we go.
Okay, Clippers 27-15 lead. It's Swampscott with the ball as we start the second half.
Swampscott, I think, is going to try to shoot the ball outside a little more.
After a very low 8-4 second quarter. There's Goldman's shot, is no good. Rebound by Swampscott, and knocked out of bounds by Newburyport. So we found out who that missing foul was on. Number 12, Juden, got a foul. I have no idea when that happened.
Okay.
All right, Goldman will put the ball in play. All the way out to him. Stolen away by Archie. Archie down to Coriel. Coriel lays it up, no good. Leahy with a rebound, with a burn.
I think George surprises a lot of defensive players on how high he can jump.
Three-point shot is no good. Robertson with a rebound. Cross court goes to Archie. Archie makes a good move, lays it up around the rim, no good. Augustin with the ball. His shot is no good. Rebounded by McLaren, Parker McLaren. Coriel to Parker. Back to Coriel. Robertson in the corner. And it's going away by Goldman. Goldman drives, lays it up around and in.
And Jake lead, Goldman. The lead is 10 now.
27-17.
Newburyport can't get lackadaisical. They still got to try to be sharp.
Cross court it goes. Coriel in the corner now underneath the Parker. McLaren. Parker's turnaround jump. There's no good rebound by Augustin.
Augustin did not start, but he's played, I think, every minute since.
Yeah, once he get in, you're right. He hasn't left the court. Goldman with it. Underneath Leahy. Leahy, a turnaround jumper is no good. Rebound by Casey McLaren. Coriel. Over to Robertson. Now Parker McLaren, his shot is no good, and there's a foul on the play. It's going to be on. Goldman, his second in the half.
I wouldn't be surprised if Coach Clay kind of stays with this original five out there a little longer than normal. Let's try to get some rhythm and pace to this second half and try to keep that 10-point lead.
One free throw by Parker McLaren, one more coming. 28-17 Clippers. And 29-17, two free throws by Parker McLaren. Goldman brings the ball up. He almost lost the ball, but he got the pass off, and it's going to be a traveling against the big blue, the Newburyport ball.
Yeah, I think we got a little lucky there. I think George Coriel caught the sneaker of Goldman and tripped him, but he didn't go down, so he didn't get the call.
Coriel with the ball. Over to Robertson. Cross court it goes. Oh. Save though by the Clippers. Clippers have it. Robertson now to Archie for three. It's no good. Rebound by Leahy. Clippers look like cold after that first quarter. All the way down the court, no good by O'Brien. Rebound by the Clippers. Parker with the rebound. Parker McLaren. Now it's Coriel. Coriel drives down and he's fouled on the play. I think that's on Leahy. His first. Second on the team. Casey McLaren will put the ball in play. Coriel. Now it's Archie. Casey for three, no good. Rebounded by Leahy. Throw it to O'Brien. Augustine pass off, and there's going to be a foul on the play. Casey McLaren, that's his second. First on the team in this half. Oh, and this will be an offensive foul called against,
is that 14?
And Leahy, that's his second. So 4:42 to go in the third. Clippers lead 29-17. Correa with the ball. To Archie. Robertson. Archie back over again to Coriel. It's inside Casey. Casey, a turnaround jumper is good. Casey McLaren has eight.
Yeah, that's his sweet spot right there, top of the key.
31-17, Clippers. Out of bounds. The Newburyport ball. The pass was just out of bounds. I don't think the player was looking. And Swampscott calls timeout. So I started to say 1 minute ago. That's the timeout.
Yeah.
You know what's so funny at a hockey game? You're watching the game, and all of a sudden, when there's a timeout, they show the clock running down.
Yeah.
People stop it. The clock's running.
The clock's running, yeah, exactly. And sometimes I'll do the clock over there for the freshman basketball game, and I'll look up, and I'll see the clock running, and I'll get all flustered because I know I turned it off, but then I see the clock running.
So Clippers with a 14-point lead here in the third quarter.
Well, one of Newburyport's finest just came out and did his version of a triple jump back toe, whatever. Got a big cheer from the Newburyport co-eds over there, which is the biggest crowd, I think, of the year, Richie.
Yeah, I agree. The Penteca game is a big crowd, but this tops it.
And this tops it, yeah. Now I think Kyle Hodgson, the AD, is telling the staff over there that's not allowed.
All right, Clippers with the ball. Coriel to Archie. In the corner, Archie drops it, but gets it back. Casey McLaren out front in the top of the circle. 4 minutes to go in the third quarter. Correa, nice move, passes back out to Casey McLaren. McLaren, the foul line, has it knocked away. Tipped up and picked up by the Clippers. 1 second to get the shot off just in time. It's no good. As good heads up play by Correa just to get the ball up there. Anything could happen.
Yeah. Like you said, he's heads up play. He knew the clock was down there to 1 second and shot it up there.
Augustine with the ball. Nice move there by Byrne. Lays up there. Turn around shot there by Jackson Byrne. That's 5 points.
That might be a matchup that they might want to exploit. Byrne has a little more height on him.
31-19. In the corner, McLaren, no good for three, and it was Casey who took the shot. Rebound by Swampscott. Augustine with the ball. Clippers by 12. Augustine for three. It's no good. And the ball rebounded and up by O'Brien. The shot is no good. Could have been a foul on O'Brien. This rebound action here, but they let it go. And McLaren's fouled by Byrne, and that's going to be his fourth, I think, if it is Byrne. Yep. That's his fourth. And Parker McLaren is going to go line to shoot two. And for Byrne, that's his fourth foul.
Yeah, they're going to have to take him out until at least the 5 minute mark of the fourth period.
McLaren's first shot is good. And Byrne is replaced.
And he is their top scorer. Once again, I was told he had 11 three-pointers the other night in the game.
And Shot's no good. Rebound by Costas, I think. 23 was, Campos. Shot is no good. Bryan got the rebound and put it in.
One of the advantages of taking outside shots is that the rebounds usually come off a lot farther than if you're taking layups. And so if you're on the offensive end, you have a better chance of getting rebounds, which just happened.
Cross court, it goes to Robertson for three. No good. Rebound by Augustin. Swanson got a chance to put it under double figures. The shot is no good. Rebound by Coriel. Coriel quickly down court. Coriel drives, lays up, no good. And Casey with it. And he slipped and he goes out of bounds. It'll be Swampscott ball. So Clippers up by 11 with 1:59 to go in the third quarter.
And you can correct me if I'm wrong here, Richie, but I don't think they've had a substitute this whole period. Newburyport.
Bovey's in there. He didn't start the period.
He did not start the third period?
I don't know. He might have. I'm trying to think.
I think he did. No. I think Ryan Archie was in.
Archie was in, yeah. Augustin. O'Brien. O'Brien's shot. He's got a soft touch when he gets it in there.
And he's a big kid, too. He looks like a football player.
32-23. Over to Coriel. 1:39 to go in the third. Casey in the corner, back to Coriel. Robertson. Parker McLaren, a tough angle. The shot is no good. Rebound by Parker. And it's going to be a jump ball. Nice block. Nice defensive play. And possession arrow stays with Newburyport.
Yeah, Parker's a little upset, but he's got to get over it and get on to the next play.
Looked like he had a good block on that.
I thought it was a good block, too.
Up now, what do we got? Okay.
Jacob Robertson. He's throwing the ball into. Look for Parker or Casey. Casey's
out to Casey. Coriel has it. Robertson inside. It goes to Parker McLaren, and it's no good. Puts up again. No good. Casey with it. No good. Parker. No good. Parker again, and this time he's fouled.
Relentless. That's the word, that adjective that comes to mind
about
right
six
now.
Six shots up. You missed a shot.
Yeah. You didn't give up.
O'Brien with a foul. And Parker to shoot two.
Parker and Casey do have 3-4 inches, I think, on the tallest player out there for Swampscott, which I think is number 24, Max Pagnotta.
Second one's no good. Rebound by O'Brien. Campos is good. That is Campos.
And the lead's down to 7. A minute left.
32-25.
Steve, come on! Yes! Point!
Point! Casey in the corner for 3 is no good. Ball's loose, and it's going to be a foul against the Clippers.
Swampscott's definitely got the momentum going here.
Foul's going to be on Bobby.
They score here. Newburyport's got a dogfight here. Ryan Archie coming back in, going to give Casey an extended spell on the bench so he can get his breath.
46.2 seconds to go in the quarter. Clippers down by, Clippers up by 7. It's the closest Swamps has been in a long time since the first quarter. Augustin all the way. His shot is no good, but he's fouled.
It's only the third team foul.
But he was driving, so he's going to get the shot anyway.
It's going to be a shooting foul.
Yep. Robertson's the foul. That's his third. And Augustin is at the line to shoot. He's 1-for-5 so far from the foul line. 1-for-6. Yeah. He feels good. 4 points now for him. 32-26. second free throw for 32-27. Clippers lead is down to 5. Archie. To Parker. Parker with a little jumper. It's no good. Augustin with the rebound. And it's going to be a foul on Bovee. His second. Fourth in the team.
So I think Newburyport's going to benefit from the minute that they have off in between the periods, because Swampscott's definitely got the momentum here, and they can cut the lead down to one basket with this possession here. 17 Augustin. Seconds to
Augustin
go.
Augustin has the ball. Looks like they're going to try to hold for one. Going to try to clear off for Augustin, it looks like. And a timeout, an offensive foul, it looks like.
Might have been an illegal pick.
An elbow.
Okay, 9.4 seconds.
Also in 23 campus.
Look for George to drive.
Correa over to, back to McLaren. McLaren's shot is no good. Parker, it tipped up, no good. Shot again, and the buzzer sounds, and the quarter's over. Clippers scored 5 points that quarter. And Swanson scored 12. So Clippers all scored 12-5 in that quarter.
Swampscott definitely had the best of them that quarter. So we're going to see what Coach Clay can come out, what kind of offense he's going to do. Is he going to switch up his defense, maybe press a little more? We'll see. But Newburyport is in a game. Got some dancers down there.
Oh, I see. Oh,
yeah.
Oh, the kids there. Yeah, look at them.
Everyone's having fun. So to begin the fourth period here, Casey's gonna get a little extended break on the bench. Got Bovee in there, we got Parker, Ryan Archie.
Okay, so Clippers up by 5. Swampscott with the ball. O'Brien, got it by Parker. The shot by O'Brien is good, he's heating up. He's got 10 points now. 32-29. Shot is no good. Rebound by Augustin. Down court it goes to O'Brien. Over to Augustin.
Looking for Byrne underneath.
He's back in the game with 4 fouls.
Yeah, he's got.
O'Brien's shot for 3 is no good. Rebound by Coriel. Coriel's going to drive. Laser all the way up and in. George Coriel, a nice basket. 34-29, Clippers. Augustin with the ball. All the way, drives, lays it up and in. Good move by Augustin. He's got 7 points. 34-31, Clippers. Coriel with the ball. Archie for 3. No good, rebound by Byrne. Byrne loses the ball out of bounds. It'll be Newburyport ball. Casey McLaren back in the ball game for Newburyport, replacing Bovee. 6:40 to go in the game. Clippers up by 3.
Tom Scott back into 2-3 defense.
Coriel over to Casey McLaren. Kapaka. Robertson has it, and it's going to be thrown out of the way, and it's, ooh, out of bounds, back court. Nice attempt by the Clippers that time to try to, Archie, to keep that in play. Augustin with the ball, 6:23 to go in the game. at least in regulation. Shot is, basket's good by Augustin, and he's got to go to the line.
Well, I think that was an offensive foul.
I thought it might have been called offense. Maybe the basket's good and then an offensive foul.
Years ago, they used to be able to count the basket and call an offensive foul.
And they did here.
Did they? They gave him the 2 points?
Yeah.
Okay. I wasn't sure if that was allowable here at the high school level.
They didn't record the foul on the scoreboard yet, though. They didn't record a foul. I thought the basket was good and there was a foul. And they haven't recorded it and they haven't changed it on the scoreboard. So what they call, nothing?
Well, no, there was definitely an offense. Sometimes it does not count as a team foul.
They put up as a team foul now, as a seventh foul.
Yes.
But they didn't show it on the scoreboard yet. Oh, stolen away by Augustin. And the foul is on McLaren. Parker McLaren with the foul. And Augustin is going to go to the line. There will be two shots for Augustin. Chance, it's 34-31 Newburyport. Oh, wait a minute, they took the basket away now. They had 33 up there, they took it away.
33, yeah.
Yep. So they took the basket away. One guy waved it good, the other referee said no. So it's 34-33. Coriel, cross court goes to Parker McLaren. Parker fakes the outside shot and he loses the ball.
And he's down.
Campo's shot is no good. Rebound by the Clippers. Robinson with the rebound, and he's fouled as he called out timeout in the report. So that was an interesting, Casey McLaren is hurt. He went down, and that ball down, he went down hard.
Yeah, it's been a physical game for him.
So let's get back to that shot. First of all, the shot, that drive by Augustin. First they called the basket good. We thought he was going to take a foul shot. Then they said no, so then we saw they put a foul on the scoreboard. It would be against them.
Yeah.
But they didn't show the player's foul on the board.
Yeah.
And then next thing you know, the 2 points were taken off the board.
Yeah, about a minute later.
Yeah. But the referee did give the signal the basket being good.
I saw the signal for the basket, and then he put his hand behind his head, indicating an offensive foul. And then they went over. And they discussed it for a bit, and they decided that the basket was not going to count. Here comes the athletic one.
Also a little bit of bleach. So the Clippers lead by one. Clippers had 19 points in the first quarter. They've only scored 15. In the last
two quarters and three minutes.
Corey out with the ball. Clippers up by one.
Defense!
And that's a foul against the Clippers.
Yeah, that's on Bovee. Illegal pick.
That's his third. Now every shot, the rest of the way is going to be a shooting foul. Every foul.
Yeah, that will probably decide the winner also, whoever can make the most.
Byrne back in the lineup for Swampscott. And Augustin, no good. Rebounded by the Clippers. Coriel has it over to Archie. Robinson has it stolen away by Augustin. Quickly down court, it goes to O'Brien.
It's an open three.
O'Brien has a foul by Bovee. That's the fourth on Bovee.
Yeah.
And O'Brien is going to go to the line to shoot two.
Yeah, don't look now, but Newburyport can find themselves trailing in this game.
See former Newburyport coach Tom Letalian over in the corner here watching the game. He's talking with him at halftime.
Where is he now?
He's over there. I don't know what he's doing now.
No, we're coaching.
Yeah, I don't know. Casey McClellan back in the lineup for the Clippers.
Okay, so one more shot to tie the game here. We have 5 minutes and 4 seconds left.
Second shot is good. And we're tied. And that's the first time I think the game's been tied. 34-34. Robinson in the corner for three, no good. Rebound by Coriel. Coriel puts it up around, no good. Rebound by Kempis, out of bounds, and he swaps the ball. 4:44, 4:47 to go in the game.
Sorry.
They keep shifting Byrne in and out. They take him out for defense when they can, and he comes back in for offense.
Yeah, well, he's got four fouls,
take the chance
right?
of that foul, right. O'Brien, his shot is good. O'Brien. He's got 13 and Swampscott takes the lead. 36-34. Coriel with the ball. Archie for three. It's no good. Rebound by Coriel to Parker McLaren. Robertson to Parker. And jump shot is around him. No good. Rebound. Clippers have it. Coriel puts it back up again around. No good. And O'Brien has it. Nice steal by Archie, but there's going to be a foul on the play. That's his second, and it's going to be a 1-1. So O'Brien will be shooting 1-1. Second foul on O'Brien, I mean on Archie. Good. 37-34. O'Brien's got 14 points.
Hey, he's had a good game, hasn't he?
15 points, and it's 38. Took him down by four.
He's got a nice touch from the foul line.
In the corner, Casey McLaren for three. He's got it. Casey for three. And it's 38-37 in favor of Swampscott. Three-point shot is no good. And rebound by Robertson. That shot was taken by Pagnotto, who had has a three in the first quarter, and that's been it. Robertson with a little shot. It's good. Robertson and the Clippers take the lead. Robertson has 10 points. It's 39-38 Clippers. And Swampscott called timeout.
Something we haven't talked about yet, Richie, is Casey McLaren, I think, needs 20 points to pass Rachel Weil as the all-time leading scorer here at Newburyport High School. There is kind of a unofficial...
Yeah, Junior Degris.
Junior Degris that he would need another 20 points in another game to pass Junior Degris.
Yeah.
But I don't think it's an official record.
Yeah, that's before they kept all records. I guess no one researched it. So, anyway, 39-38, Clippers by one. And right now, Casey has 11 points. That was a big three.
That was.
That could be
right
a good
there.
Confidence builder because he's been on it, but he just. So Clippers lead 39-30.
Clippers are up by one.
Well, that's right. Yeah, because Robertson got the basket right after. Right, Clippers up by one. All right, Pagnotto puts the ball in play over to Robertson. Almost stolen by the Clippers. Pagnotto gets it. Now it is stolen by the Clippers. Parker has it. Reflected by Casey over to Parker.
Yeah. Too soon to start running any clock. They got to get into their offense.
Yeah. Coriel over to Archie.
There's a good shot.
For three is no good. Rebounded out of bounds. It'll be
Casey, I think, has his hand on it.
All right. Clippers up by one. O'Brien with the ball. 3 minutes to go in the game. Kablan makes a good move, loses it, and it's taken away by Casey McClellan, and he throws it away. Couldn't quite get it down. It's out of bounds. He tried to get a pass, but goes too far from Robertson. Great idea, just a little bit too far. O'Brien has the ball. Down court it goes to Augustin. Stolen, no, not stolen away. Nice play by Augustin as he threw the ball off of Coriel. That was a good play. I'm impressed with Augustin. He's had a great game.
Yeah, and he's only a sophomore, I think, Richie.
Yeah, wow.
Yeah.
And blocked. That was stopped by Casey Apaka. Let me see. It was Casey that blocked that one. And they kept the ball in play, too, which is even better for the Clippers. Clippers by one, 2:30 to go in the game. Robertson, Coriel with the ball. Over to Archie for three. No good, rebound by O'Brien. Stolen away by Casey McClellan, he puts up no good. Coriel with the rebound. And there's gonna be a jump ball. Or do they call a foul? The jump ball, possession arrow goes to Newburyport.
Looks like it's going to be out of bounds for Newburyport. George Coriel.
Yeah, well, it was a jump ball, so the possession arrow was Newburyport. Out it goes to Coriel from the foul line. Now over to Archie. Casey McClellan in the corner for three. It's no good. Tipped up and rebounded by O'Brien. O'Brien with the ball. Approaching 2 minutes to go in the game. Augustin has it. And timeout called by Swampscott. I think that's their fourth. They have one left.
Just when we come back to the
spectators are not allowed on the court until after the players have left the gym.
When we come back to the action, Richie, keep an eye on Ryan Archie covering Byrne. He's really, really in his grill, and we got to be careful that he doesn't get a foul because he's getting real physical with him. So keep an eye on that matchup.
Got a competition going back and forth between the Newburyport fans and the cheerleaders for Swampscott about doing cartwheels with backward flips. I think we'll have to give the nod to Swampscott. Although you got to give the kids of Newburyport credit for trying.
All in good spirit.
And you like to see it. I didn't hear the anthem, but the Newburyport cheering section was sang the anthem.
Yes.
I don't know if you caught that or not. But
yeah.
Okay, 2 minutes to go in the game. Newburyport's up by one. Both teams are in a shooting situation. Eight fouls against Newburyport, seven against Swampscott.
So keep an eye on Ryan Archie right in front of us as he gets
Augustin
on
with the
Byrne.
Ball. Augustin drives, and it's stolen away by Coriel, and he's fouled by Augustin. And that's only the third against Augustin.
The 1-1.
And Coriel is the line shooting 1-1. Notice the Clippers all dressed in black today, too, the fan section. Black shirts, black jerseys, and pants.
Yeah.
They always have a theme. Free throws no good. Rebounded by Byrne down to Augustin. Augustin drives and passes back to O'Brien for three. It's no good. Nice rebound there. You got that one. I don't know how he gets up for those rebounds all the time. A three on nothing, and it's stuffed by McLaren. Casey with a stuff. Now down goes Augustin. This shot is no good. Rebound by Parker. And we have a timeout called by Newburyport.
Big sequence right there.
That was a nice steal by the Clippers. Then you knew Casey was going to stuff the ball, but to get down here at that point. So Casey McClellan now has 13 points. The Clippers lead by three.
Yeah, and even more important, I think, is that now Newburyport has the fans involved. They have a little momentum, and that could carry them through the end of the game. Swampscott has had, I think, the better of the second half. The scoring and pace. The way they wanted to play the game, it was ugly. There was a lot of chippiness. because Newburyport, I think, has the height and the athleticism. So up until right there, Swampscott had the better of Newburyport.
But Newburyport scored the last 7 points as they were trailing 38-34. Sparked by that three-point basket by Casey, and then a basket by Robertson, and then the dunk by Casey.
Come on, Swampscott!
Casey's pumped up to see how he went to the stands, the cheers, to get them going after
them
that
all,
one, too.
Yeah, getting them all going.
Emotional. Flip the ball. Flip is up by three. Out to Casey. Archie, way outside for three. It's no good. And, oh, it hit the guide wire, so it's out of bounds. It'll be over to Gloucester. Gloucester, I mean Swampscott. How'd I get Gloucester? O'Brien with the ball. Cook is up by three. O'Brien's shot is no good, but he's fouled by Casey McLaren. That's the third on Casey.
And that stops the clock.
And O'Brien will go to line shooting two. Cam O'Brien. 15 points so far. Two shots coming.
Yeah!
That's good. Free throws by O'Brien, makes it 41-40.
All right, so I think they're going to try to set up Casey for a shot here. It's crunch time. He's the guy you got to go to. There he is, right there.
It's knocked away, but Casey gets a nice pass to Coriel, but he travels.
Yep.
41-40 in favor of Newburyport. 58 seconds to go. O'Brien with it. O'Brien drives, passes out in the corner, and now back up to Augustin. Underneath it goes to O'Brien. O'Brien brings it back outside again. And the shot by O'Brien. Wow, how did he get that one off?
Casey didn't want to foul him. You don't want to stop the clock.
42-41, Swampscott. Casey. Line rip, no good. Rebound by Swampscott. And Gordon is fouled by Coriel.
Yeah, no intentional foul there. George went over and kind of reached down to foul, grabbed his shirt. Referees are talking about it, though.
Yep. It's going to be... That's 10, so it's going to be two shots. Burn is 0 for 1 from the foul line, but he's a pretty good shooter, so. That's good. Makes it 6 for him. Big basket coming here, big free throw. Two free throws, 44-41. 19 seconds ago, Spurs are going to call a timeout. Now they do. Casey takes a long three-pointer, it's no good, but the buzzer, I mean, they call timeout.
All right, we'll see what kind of play they run here.
You might see Swampscott try to foul quick, so Newburyport has got a chance to get a three-point shot off.
And they would have to shoot one and one. So, looking at the statistics, according to this, it looks like Parker McLaren would be the person to foul. At 69%, Jacob Robertson, 73%, Casey McLaren, 74%, George Coriel, 72%. So they're all about the same, but if you're into analytics, you would follow Parker McLaren.
He's 6-11, and he did make 4 in a row. Excuse me. Yeah, he's 6-11 in this game, and he had made 4 in a row. I mean, they do have a bunch of three-point shooters.
Right, Ryan can shoot it. The only one that doesn't shoot a lot of threes is George Coriel. Jacob, Parker, Casey, and Ryan Archie, all three-point shooters. So they could use Casey as kind of a decoy here. Here we go, 16 seconds.
Archie, Robertson. Archie for three. It's good. Timeout.
Yeah, I think they're going to have to put some more time back on that clock. I would think at least 3 seconds back on the clock, game clock. But that's going to give Swampscott the last chance in regulation to try to win it.
That was back deep, too. 44-44. And the Clippers kind of fortified. They only put a second back on. 4.3. Clippers got to be careful of a foul here, because a foul would be just as bad as allowing out at the basket.
Right, yeah.
Because it's going to be two shots. And they're going to get the ball underneath the Newburyport basket. It's not like in the pros where you get the ball at half court.
Yeah. I don't know what's going on over there, but it wouldn't surprise me if they put some more time on.
They did add one already.
Yeah. But I think they might add some more.
Well, I didn't even realize we had three referees. I just noticed the first time. At least the referees have been part of the game, I guess, because I didn't even notice they had three out there. And that was the last timeout for them. So if they can't get the ball in play, they can't call a timeout to regroup.
Sometimes in these situations, the defensive team, which is Newburyport right now, will get behind one of the Swampscott's player, and when they break to go to the other end, they'll get run over, they'll flop, and see if they can't get an offensive foul on Swampscott.
I'm thinking they're going to go to one or 21. Burns the shooter, but stole it away by Coriel. He lays it up. No, it's good, and that's it. Coriel, the basket. Is it good? It's good. The referee called it good.
Yeah. George has won it.
Coriel stole the ball. It was like Havlicek stole the ball. Coriel stole the ball and he laid it up for a win.
Yeah, look at the crowd.
Wow, what a victory. George Coriel stole the ball and laid it in. That ball just bounced around the rim too. I didn't know it was going to go in. What a finish. George Coriel with the steal on the basket at the buzzer. And it was Swampscott's ball.
I don't think anybody saw that coming. Well, I got to congratulate Swampscott. They played a great game here tonight. One of those games where no one deserves to lose. Unfortunately, the ball bounced in Newburyport's favor.
Thanks, Chris. Thank you. Okay, so we're going to recap this game here. As the Clippers led 19-11 after the first quarter, then they only outscored Swampscott 8-4 in the second to make it 27-15 Newburyport. Swampscott outscored Newburyport 12-5 in the third to make it 32-27 Newburyport. And Swampscott outscored Newburyport 17-14 in the third, in the final, but it was a 46-44 victory. And the steal by George Coriel, and then he laid it up at the buzzer. It's just amazing.
Yeah, I think it was 4.3 seconds. He deflected the pass. So that took a good second and a half. Then he took three or four steps in and put it up right at the buzzer. That'll go down in his memory, I think, for the rest of his life.
So we'll try to make a recap of all this here. Just total up my points. Okay, so for the Clippers, George Coriel with 7 points, the big one coming, the steal and basket at the end of the game. Ryan Archie with 3 points, 2 3-point baskets he made. Very key at the time. He got the big one that tied the game at 44-44, and that was from downtown. Jake Robertson with 10, but he had 8 in the first quarter. He ended up with 2 3-pointers. Casey McLaren at 13, but he had the big 3-pointer that turned the game around. I think gave the Clippers back the lead. Then he dunked the ball, and that was a big momentum shift.
That sure was. And then Swampscott came down the other end and missed the layup.
Parker McLaren had 10 points, a bunch of rebounds, and some block shots. for a total of 46. The Clippers overall had five three-pointers, seven three-pointers. They made two in the last quarter. So seven threes. And from the foul line, Newburyport was 10 out of 22. And for Swampscott, Cole Cassidy did not score. Jake Goldman had two. Jackson Byrne, seven. And a good tip of the hat to Ryan Archie for the great job he did in covering Byrne throughout the game.
Yeah, he sure did.
Jack Leahy, two. Max Pagnotto, three. And he had a three-pointer for the first basket, and that was it. Andrew Augustin, I thought, played a great game. He had 9 points, but he's all over the place. And Cam O'Brien, another fine job. He had 19 points. And both Augustin and O'Brien went starters. They came off the bench. And then Campo set two for a total of 44. Swampscott ended up with two for three from the for three-pointers. But they had a lot of foul shots. They made number three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. They made 12. They took 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 12 for 20 from the foul line. But 46-44, I don't know what the Clippers will be. That'll be announced. You can watch the paper for that. And it'll probably be within a couple of days, and it's probably going to be home. They still should get a home shot.
I asked Casey today. He said yes. And I think at Minuteman Tech, is that a tech school, Minuteman?
Yeah.
Or Draken.
Okay.
Will be here probably, I'm guessing, Wednesday or Thursday. I just want to say how happy I am for George Coryell. I think he went through the majority of this season not at 100%. You could tell he wasn't driving to the hole. He wasn't playing the one-on-one defense the way he's capable. And then maybe two, 3 weeks ago, he started driving to the hole and feeling better. And then for him to use his feet and his athletic ability to win this tournament game for Newburyport, I just feel so good for George to be able to do that.
Well, it was a great victory for the Clippers. They had the lead all the way, and when they fell behind, they didn't panic, and they came back. And again, tip of the hat to Coryell for making that great play at the end of the steal and the basket. And on to the next game. And Jeff, I wish you and Drew the success in the rest of the tournament, as I won't be here. Now I'll be heading down south.
We're heading down to Florida, Red Sox Nation.
Looking forward to following the game and on how you guys are doing and how the Clippers are doing. Wish both the hockey team and the basketball team luck. And so for tonight, the final score for Jeff, first for Jeff Foley, Richie Eaton, and our cameraman David Creamer. Final score, Newburyport 46, Swampscott 44.
Good night, everyone.